Good afternoon to everyone. Today we are going to start the topic hardware, software, peripheral devices and processors. In today's class, we will study hardware, software, peripheral devices means input and output devices and processors. This is the syllabus of Unit 1, Brief History of Computer on the Basis of Hardware. In previous class, we have studied about what is computer, block diagram of computer, and generations of computer, types of computer. In today's class, we are going to discuss about hardwares, softwares, peripheral devices, and processors. So this is the introduction of computer system. A computer is an electronic device that accept or get the instructions, commands, or input from the user, process it, and give the result or output or information back to the users. Basically, it is divided into two main categories. One is hardware and second is software. So computer is a device, it's an electronic device that accept the request from client or user, process it according to the requirements and get the result back or generate or produce the result and send back it to the client. And it is divided into two categories, hardware and software. Here, hardware. Hardware is a physical aspect of computers, telecommunication or other devices that we can touch, or it is tangible part of the computer system, like monitor, like keyboard, like CPU, the parts of the computer system that we can touch is called a hardware. And it's a physical aspect of computer and it is tangible. Tangible means touchable. We can touch it, we can feel it. For example, like a keyboard, like mouse, like speakers, like CPU, like printers, they are all called hardwares. That we can see, that we can touch, that is called software or hardware. Now we have our four types of hardware: internal hardware, input hardware, output hardware, and storage hardware. So we have four types of hardware: internal, input, output, and storage hardware. Hardware is the part of the computer system that we can touch, physically that we can touch is called a hardware. First, we have our internal hardware. Internal hardware is also known as a components. It includes CPU, central processing unit, motherboard, RAM, random access memory, ROM, read-only memory. So the CPU, motherboard, RAM, and ROM, they come under the internal hardware. Means internal components of the computer system that we can see, that we can touch. This is central processing unit, known as CPU. It is the brain of the computer and it directs and controls the entire computer system and perform all the arithmetical and logical operations. So central processing unit or CPU is known as the brain of the computer system. It is responsible for the entire control and management of the computer system. And all your arithmetic and all your logical operations are performed by central processing unit. This is the diagram of, these are the images of central processing units. CPU look like this. AMD 64. And these are the images of central processing unit. Central processing unit is the main component of the computer system. It is known as brain of the computer system. And all your mathematical, all your logical operations and calculations are performed in a CPU. And these are the images of CPU, how it looks like. Next, we have a motherboard. The physical arrangement in a computer that contains computer basic software and components. Basically, motherboard is just like a chip where we have this different components. See, first to see the diagram. This is the diagram of motherboard. It looks like this. It has connectors. DRAM memory means dynamic random access memory. And this is called ATX power connector. And this is the CPU fan and heatsink mounting points. And this white one is called a CPU socket. That is called North Bridge. This is the diagram or image of motherboard. That is called this black one is called a AGP slot. And this is the South Bridge. These are the North Bridge and these are the South Bridge. We have a PCI slot. This is this black one is called CMOS backup battery. CMOS means complementary metal oxide semiconductor. And all these components are connectors for integrated peripherals. It means it is used for connecting either by using all these connectors. You can attach your pen drive. You can even insert a CD, floppy disk, hard disk. So these are for the connections for connecting your peripheral devices for connecting input-output devices. So this is how the motherboard looks like. It has different connectors, fan, even bridges, north bridge, south bridge, different slots, PCI slot, AGP slots, backup battery, different connectors for connecting your peripherals, like for connecting input and output devices, like for connecting the pen drive, for collecting, for inserting the disk, floppy disk, hard disk. Then we have our DRAM memory slot, means dynamic random access memory. We have our IDE connectors. So this is the diagram of motherboard. AGP. We have an AGP slot. So AGP stands for Accelerated Graphic Board. It is used for graphic cards. Next, we have a PCI slot. PCI stands Peripheral Component Interconnect. It is used for input-output devices. And in motherboard, we have a microprocessors, coprocessors, memory, basic input-output system, commonly known as BIOS, expansion slots, interconnecting circuitry. So motherboard look like this. It has various components like memory slot, like PCI slot, AGP slot, different types of bridges like South Bridge, North Bridge, fan, CPU socket, and different types of connector for different peripheral devices. This is memory unit. Memory unit is the area in a computer system where programs and data are stored. We have two types of memory, RAM, which is called random access memory, ROM, which is known as read-only memory. RAM is used to store the data and programs that you will run exist only when the power is on. Whenever you switch off the computer, the data will be lost. It means it is not permanent, it is the temporary memory. Next, we have our ROM, read-only memory. It contains the pre-programmed computer instructions such as BIOS, basic input-output systems, and it is the permanent memory. If there will be no any power supply, the data will not be lost. So random access memory is the temporary memory. Read-only memory is a permanent memory. One is volatile and second is non-volatile memory. So memory unit means we have a memory where we can store data, where we can store instructions, where we can do calculations. And we have, basically we have two types of memory, RAM and ROM. RAM stands for random access memory. ROM stands for read-only memory. RAM is a temporary memory. It need power supply always. If the power is not there and if the light is off, if there is a no power availability, so data will be lost. And ROM is a permanent memory, no matter, and if there will be no any power supply, the data will remain static. Next, we have input hardwares. Input hardware consists of several external devices by which we can give information and instructions to the computer. Like a keyboard, because by using keyboard, we can enter the information into the computer. Mouse, by using the mouse, we can even select some fields, some columns. Next, we have a scanner. By using the scanner, we can do the scanning of any document. Next is keyboard. You know very well, keyboard is an input device and it is used to store the or enter the text, enter the data. We have a different types of keyboard, traditional keyboards. Some keyboards are flexible, that is easy to roll up and roll down. Then we have our ergonomic keyboards. These are the types of keyboards. We have a wireless keyboards. We have a PDA keyboards. So keyboard is an input device, which is used to enter the text, enter the data, enter the numbers into the computer system. We have a various types of keys on the keyboard. We have a shift keys. We have a arrow keys. We have a 12 functional keys. We have a space bar. We have an enter key. So keyboard is basically used to enter the information into computer system. Next is mouse. Mouse is also an input device. It is used to select the data. It is used to point the data. We have two types of mouse. One is mechanical and second is optical. Mechanical is the type of mouse that have rubber or metal ball on its underside and it can roll in any direction. Look, see on this image, it is a mechanical mouse because look at this, it has one rubber or a metal ball. So it is easy to roll everywhere. We can move it to right direction. We can move it to left direction. So we can move it anywhere. Next, we have an optical type of mouse. This type uses a laser. In this mouse, we have a laser for detecting the mouse movement. By using laser, you have seen in your college labs, we have an optical mouse. You see, we have a light. So when it's working, light is on. When it's not working, light is off. Next is how a mouse hooks up to PC. It means how the mouse is connected with the PC. We have to connect the mouse with the PC so that it will work. Most of we know that. I think you have seen in your computer labs in our college, we have a wire with a mouse. See, these are the connectors. This is the connector, this is the connector, this is the connector. By using these connectors, we can attach the mouse with computers. ES2 mouse, serial mouse, USB, cordless mouse. We have a different types of mouse. But we have now it's a wireless mouse. These mouse don't have any wire. We does not need to connect it to the computer by using wires. So if we are working with a wireless mouse, we don't need any wire. And if you are using a wired mouse, you just need to attach the wire of mouse with the computer system. Next is scanning devices. We have different types of scanning devices. We have our optical scanners, we have our card readers, we have our barcode readers, even we have our MICR, magnetic ink character recognition. These are the examples of scanning device. In now you have seen in all the shopping malls and most of the shopping areas, they are using a barcode. At the end of the product or on the back side of any product, there is some numbers that is called barcode, and we can scan it by using a barcode device. So that we have a different types of scanning device. When we put the scanner or when we put the light on that code, we get the entire detail like its brand, its quantity, its price, its expiry date. So these are the images of scanning devices, how it works. Next, we have an output hardware. Output hardware consists of some internal and external devices that are used to transfer information from computer CPU to computer users. It means output hardware is used to give the result back to the user. For example, we have a monitor. Monitor means it may be a CPU, it may be a laptop. Monitor means some screen from where we can read the data, from where we can get the information. Printer, you know very well, printer is the device from where we can get the printed document. And speaker is also an output device where we can get the information back. But speaker is both at a time. It's both an input device or output device. Now still I'm speaking and you are listening. And when you will speak, I will listen. It means it will act as both an input device and output device. Types of monitor, CRT, cathode ray tube. It looks like this. This is the image of CRT. Next, we have a liquid crystal display, LCD. LCD is a flatter or smaller in a size as compared to CRT. This is the image or shape of CRT, and this is how the LCD looks like. LCD or CRT. Next, we have a printer. You know, we all know that printer is an output device. It is used to print the documents. We can print documents, we can print images. Means we can do different types of printing by using the printers. We have basically two types of printers, impact printer and non-impact printers. Impact printer use pressure by physically striking the paper. Example of impact printer are daisy wheel printers, line printers, dot matrix printers and band printers. Non-impact printers, in non-impact printer, we does not need to put pressure or press on the paper. But instead of produce character, it use lasers, it use ink spray, it use photography or heat. The main difference between impact and non-impact printer is that in impact printer, we need to use the pressure by physically striking the paper. We need to put some force or some pressure on the paper so that it gets printed. But non-impact printer is now a laser printer because they use lasers, they use ink spray. These are the types of printer. It's a dot matrix. It is a dot matrix printer. It is a laser printer and it is a inject printer. See, dot matrix printer look like this. Laser printer look like this. Inject printer looks like this. One is asking what is the difference between LCD and LED. LCD stands for liquid crystal display, whereas LED stands for light emitting diodes. So there is a difference between both devices. It has a liquid crystals in case of LED, and in case of light emitting diodes, we have some other technology that can be used, but both works as an output device. LED or LCD both work as an output device. And CRT is also known as a cathode ray tube, and it is used to display the information. CRT, LCD, LED, all are used for output devices. And all are used to display the images, the text, the videos, everything they are used to display. Whereas in LED, there is a use of some diodes. It's a light emitting diodes. But in case of LCD, we use plasma or liquid crystals. In LCD, we use plasma or liquid crystals. But in case of LED, we are going for diodes. So there is a little bit of difference between LED and LCD. LED is smaller or slimmer than LCD. So LED is so slim as compared to LCD. Next, we have a storage hardware. It means what types of storage media we have on which we can store the data. You know very well, we have a hard disk, we have a floppy disk, we have a CD-ROM, even we have a pen drives. All these are the devices where we can store our data so that we can use it later on. This is floppy disk. This is the most common secondary storage media. which is used to store the data. Its size is 3.5 and it can store 1.44 MB data. So floppy disk is one of the storage media which can be used to store the data so that we can access that data, we can use that data later on. Next, we have a high capacity floppy disk. It store more information as compared to floppy disk because it's a high capacity floppy disk and it's a JIP disk. It's not a normal disk, it is a JIP disk. 3.5 inches in diameter, its size is 3.5 inches. And it store more data or more information as compared to floppy disk because it's a high capacity. Next, we have a hard disk drive or hard disk. It looks like this. It has cylinder and sectors. It is made of rigid materials. Unlike floppy disk, it holds great amount of data. Basically, it is used to hold a large amount of data as compared to other disks. Next, we have optical disk. It looks like this, optical disk. A standard part of modern desktop machines, basically they used for multimedia purpose and preferred in loading applications. Most of you know about this disk. We can store any type of information in the disk. Even when we want to show the project to the teachers, we can store the project into the disk. We can copy some softwares into the disk. So this disk is very well known to everyone. Optical drives, CD-ROM, it is used for read CDs. CD writer, it can both for read and write CDs. Then these are the drivers that we need for optical disk. DVD combo DVD, it read and write CDs. So DVD combo means it can read and write CDs and read DVDs. DVD writer can read and write CDs or it can read and write DVDs, both CDs and DVDs. If you want to work with optical disk, you need to install some optical drivers. Next, we have some other secondary storage media like solid state storage, no moving parts, flash memory cards we can use for storage, we can use for USB, universal serial bus flash drives, we can use pen drives. So we have other type of storage media. These are called the cards. This is used to store the data. These are the pen drives. It's portable, movable. So instead of using floppy disk, hard disk, optical disk, we have some other storage media. We can use memory cards or we can use even a pen drives to store the data and they are easy to carry. Next, we have connecting hardware. Connecting hardware or connecting devices allow various hardware devices to be connected with each other or to be communicate with each other. Common devices are called modem. Modem, it stands for modulator and demodulator. Next, we have a LAN card. These two are the connecting devices. Modulator and demodulator. Basically, it is used to convert the analog signals to digital and digital signals to analog. This is called MO stands for modulator and DM stands for demodulator. It is used to convert the analog signals to digital signals and digital signals back to analog signals. Basically, modem is used in the telephone lines. When we talk with each other, when we call with each other, there will be a modem that convert sender analog signals to the digital signal at the receiving end, and from a receiver digital signal again convert back to the analog signal. So modem is a device that convert your signal. Either it is converted from analog to digital or digital to analog. Next, we have a LAN card. Basically, LAN card is also used to connect the devices. Modem look like this. Basically, modem is used with telephone. It's basically used with a telephone communication. When we place a call or when we start talking with each other, analog and digital signal took place. So it's a responsibility of modem, that is called modulator and demodulator, to convert the analog signal to digital and digital signal back to analog. Next, we have a LAN card, local area network card. It is used to provide a wireless internet access to the computer users in home or roaming network. Now, it's clear from its name, LAN means local area network. It means it is only within a home or within a building only. So it provide a wireless internet connection. It provide a wireless internet access among the computers, but these computers are located within a same home or even located within a same building because it's a LAN, local area network. Next, we have a peripheral devices. Peripheral devices means input-output devices. The peripheral refer to all the hardware devices that are attached to the computer and controlled by computer system. Now, in this topic, we have to see the various peripheral devices. Peripheral devices means all the devices or all the components that are connected with computer. Basically, we have two types of peripheral devices, input devices and output devices. Input devices have keyboard. We know that keyboard is the input device that is used to enter the text. Next, we have a mouse. Mouse is also, this is the image of keyboard. We all know that we use the keyboard to enter the text, the data, numbers, everything. Mouse. Mouse is also an input device. It is used to select the data. It is used to drag or drop the data. Next, we have a joystick. It look like this. This is the image of joystick. It's basically used for computer games. Next, we have a light pens. This is the diagram of light pen. This is light pen. Light pen looks like this. Next, we have stylus. It's a pen-like device commonly used with the tablet PCs and PDA. It's just like a pen-like device. See, this black pen is a stylus. It is basically used to select some text, some data, some numbers. So these are the input devices. Other pointing device, trackball, look like this. Then we have a track point. See, in between G and H, there is a one red color point that is called track point. Touchpad, where we can touch with the hands. Next, touch screen. It's not a touchpad now, it's a touch screen, but we can touch the screens. We can do calculations, even we can enter the text, select the text by touching the screen. Image capturing devices, we have our digital cameras, it's look like this. Then we have our digital video camera, it look like this. This is the digital camera and this is the digital video camera. It's basically used for photography only and it's used for photography plus videos also. Next, we have output devices. Output devices are like a monitor. Monitor means it may be a CRT, cathode ray tube. It may be a LCD, liquid crystal display. It may be a LED, light emitting diodes. Or it may be a TFT, thin film transistors. TFT is just like a monitor, but they are thin. They are small. They are slimmer in their size. Next, we have our audio speakers. Speaker is also an output device from which we can listen the information. Next, you know that printer is also an output device that give us a printed document. Next, we have parts that balance up a system unit. Means, what are the components that we need to use so that your computer can work properly. First, we have a casing or cover. Second, we have a floppy disk drive. Next, we have a hard disk drive. Next, we have a CD-ROM drive. Next, we have a modem that is called modulator and demodulator for converting analog signal to digital. Analog means that is in the form of waves, heartbeat waves. And digital means that is in the form of binary, 0101 on off. We need power supply, we need motherboard, we need microprocessor, we need memory, or we need a video card. So all these components are used to design a computer system. One is called casing or cover. The box or outer shell that houses most of the computer is usually one of the most overlooked part of the PC. It protects your computer circuit, cooling, and system organization. Most of you see CPU, central processing unit, a black color casing or cover that protect your computer or that protect your internal component from any type of circuits, from any type of heat, cooling, everything. So casing or cover is one of the component of the computer system that protect the internal component of computer. This is power supply. See, most of you have seen the back side of your CPU at your college. See, this is the back side of your CPU. This is we have to press on the power button to start your computer system. But if first you need to switch on from your CPU, then your computer system will get charged, then it start working. Basically, power supply means your computer is an electronic device. It does not work without electricity. You have to give the electricity. And for this, we need to use a power supply. Parts of power supply, it has disk drive connectors where we can attach disk. Motherboard connectors where we can attach motherboard. It has power supply fan that support the supply of power. We have a power switch which we can either switch it on or switch it off. We have an input voltage selector, we have one cover, and we have power plug receptacles. So power supply, it means we have to give the power to the computer system. When, tell me one thing, when we start working on a computer system, what we need to do? First, we need to power on it from CPU. That is called power supply. Next, we have computer hardware peripherals. A peripheral is the piece of computer hardware that is added to computer in order to expand its ability. It means we have a different types of peripherals. By using all these peripherals, we can work on. It may be a mouse, it may be a monitor, it may be a scanner, it may be a printer, it may be anything. So we have two types of devices. We have two types of slots. One is of internal and second is of external. Next, we have our internal slots. Next, see different types of slots. Slot is a device where we can attach other devices. Like if we wanted to attach my pen drive, we need some slot. So we have a different types of slot. First one is PCI slot. We have seen the PCI slot on the motherboard also. So PCI stands for peripheral component interconnect, is a common modern PC. Basically, PCI slot is a slot on your motherboard with which we can connect the various input output devices. Like we can attach pen drives, we can insert a floppy disk, hard disk. Typically, PCI card used in PCs include PCI card have network cards, PCI card have sound cards, it has modems, it has extra ports such as USB. USB means pen drive, universal serial bus or a serial, or it have a TV tuner cards and disk controllers. This is PCI slot. It looks like this. Slot 1, slot 2, slot 3, slot 4, and slot 5. This is the image of PCI slots. Next, we have an industry standard architecture, which is known as a ISA. ISA is an expansion slot found only in the window-based computer. It is only in a window-based computer. It is not in a computer having the operating system Linux, Unix. It is only have in the computers that is operating on a Windows. Its speed is so much slower as compared to PCI. Most ISA industry standard architecture cards that are available work with slower devices. Basically, its speed is so slow So it can only work with the devices whose speed is also slow, like modems. Most window-based computers today contain a mix of now in these days, most of the computers that is working on a window have the combination of both PCIe and ISA slots. So now it's getting vanished. In the coming years, they are not in a use. So ISA is one of the standard or slot that we can work in a computer that is running on a Windows. Its speed is so slow, so it can also be worked with the slow speed devices like modem. But still, it's getting paid. Now it is not in a use. Next, we have some expansion cards like sound card, video card, network card, USB cards or USB readers, firewall card. We have a different types of expansion cards like sound card, video, network, USB cards, firewall card, storage cards, modem card, and TV tuner card. These are the expansion cards. Now see it one by one. This is the sound card. Sound card is an expansion card that facilitates the input and output of audio signals to from computer under control of computer programs. Basically, sound card is used for recording the sounds. It is used for audio signals. If we want to add some audio, if we want to save some audio, then what we need to do? We need to use the sound card. Next, we have some video cards. Video card is also known as a graphic card. It is an expansion card whose function is to generate and output images to display. Basically, it's used for a graphics only, for 3D animations, for 1D animations, for 2D animations. Some video cards offer some other functionalities like we can capture the video. It has TV tuner adapters and it has a ability or capability to connect with the multiple monitors. So it's work. It can work with the multiple monitors. Multiple monitors means it can work with multiple CRTs. It can work with multiple LCDs. It can work with multiple LEDs. This is the network card. Network card is an expansion card that allow computers to communicate over a computer network. This card is used by the network devices to communicate with each other. It allow users to connect to each other by using cable or wirelessly. So basically, network card is used for networking. Most of the devices that we are using, like switches, like hub, like routers, like gateways, so all these devices can communicate with each other by using network card. External types of connections, like external means that is not inside the computer system. We have to add it externally, like pen drive. USB card. USB stands for Universal Serial Bus, just like a pen drive. So it's basically used for to get some information or to get some data from a computer, or we can use it to store some data into computer. So basically, this is used most common type of port found in the modern computers. Peripherals like printers, like keyboards, like removable flash drives and mice can be attached to the computer. It means external type of connection means which is not internally designed in the CPU. External means we are attaching as a user. I'm attaching some components with the computer, like we can attach the pen drive with the CPU. Even we can insert the disk. We can even attach the cards that is called memory cards. So these are the external connections. They are not already in your computer system or already not designed in a CPU. We can attach it externally. Next, we have a storage card. Storage card is also known as a memory card. Storage card is also known as a flash memory card or simply a memory card that is connected with your computer. You just need to attach this storage card with your computer and you can do both tasks. Either you can get the data from your computer, or if you want to store data into your computer, you can simply copy it from a memory card and save back into the computer systems. So basically it is used to either get the data from the computer or store the data into the computer system. These cards are vary, means different in both physical size and data capacity. Some cards are slimmer or store a shorter span of data, and some cards are bigger in a size and they can store a large amount of data. Most commonly cards or most famous cards in the market is a secure digital card, mini micro SD cards, or multimedia cards. These are storage card, means memory cards. Basically, they used to store the data. Either you can save the data into your computer from cards, or we can get the data from computer into the cards. Next, we have a software. You all we know that what is software? It is the set of instructions, set of the commands that we give to the computer how to work on, how to process the data. Software is of three types, system software, application software, and we have one another type of software that is called utility software. So software is nothing. It is the set of instructions, set of commands that tell the computer how to process the data into the form. Basically, it is the instructions. These are the commands that we give to the computer how to do the work. And we have system software and application software. Now see, system software. System software enables the application software to interact with computer hardware. Basically, system software is one of the software that interact with the computer hardware also. Means it can interact with the computer hardware, it can interact with the operating system for a proper management or for proper working of a computer system. System software, it's clear from its name, system. System means it may be a monitor, because we are working on a computer system. So system software interact with the computer hardware. This is the functions of system software. Manage resources, to manage the memory, to manage the processing, to manage the storage, to manage the devices like a printer. It provides user interface. System software interacts with the operating system. So the operating system provide an interface to the user to do the working. Running applications. So these are the functions or responsibilities of system software. Next, we have an application software. Basically, application software is a software that is designed by the user for its personal application. Let us suppose if I want to work on a mail merge, I will design a software for MS Word. I want to work on a MS Excel, I will use the software MS Excel. I want to work on a tables, I will go for a MS Access for a database. It means application softwares are the softwares that is designed by the programmer, by the developer, according to their application, means area of interest, which task they want to do. If I want to do the banking, I will design a banking software. If I'm working in a hospital or I'm running a hospital, I will design a software according to the hospital. So application software means you have to design the software according to your application. So there is another software that is called utility software. Basically, utility software is used like antivirus, like backup softwares. They are not comes under the category of application or system software. Utility softwares are different from application and system software. Utility software are like software, like antivirus software is called utility software, backup software is called utility software, disk driver software is called the utility software. Now, next topic is processors and its types. Basically, processors are invented by Marcion Hoof on 28 October 1937 in New York. Some of the processor manufacturers companies like Intel, very well known Intel, AMD, Qualcomm, Motorola, Samsung, IBM. These are the most famous companies. They are good processor manufacturer. Basically, processor is the device that boosts your computer system to process on. The processor or CPU is the brain of the computer. As I have already told you, without CPU, computer is nothing. Processor is also known as a CPU. The more powerful the processor is, the faster your PC will run. If you will buy a very good processor and high-speed processor, your computer will work on a very fast speed. But if your processor is of cheap price, it is of a low speed, it's a less powerful, then your computer will work accordingly. So whenever you are going to purchase your laptop, your PC, and when you have to choose your processor, select the processor or buy the processor in such a way that your entire computer performance is depend upon your processor speed. If it's good, your computer will run fast. If it is not good, your computer will run slowly. The speed of processor, that is the number of instructions per second that it can carry out. Now we have to, when we go to the market to select the processor, we have some ideas into the mind. Which processor I need to select? Now there is a one question. Which processor I need to select and how can I select the best one? It's depend upon the speed at which the processor is processing. It means, its speeds are measured in gigahertz, GHz. If the processor is processing the instructions in very fast speed, it means it's very good for your computer system. I have already told you, the more faster your processor is, the better the performance of your computer. But if you select the wrong, slow and cheap processor, it will destroy the working or performance of computer system badly. So always choose a very best and wisely a good processor for your computer system. Processor is known as CPU, and this is the diagram of CPU. We have an input, storage media, CPU, central processing unit. CPU is divided into two categories. Central processor is further divided into ALU, arithmetic logic unit, or control unit. Control unit is responsible for controlling the entire computer system. ALU for arithmetic and logical calculations, means for adding some numbers, for some doing some logics. And we have a memory. Memory is for storing the data. It may be a RAM, it may be ROM, it may be cache memory, it may be registers, it may be a secondary memory. And last we have output, where we can show the result back to the users. This is the diagram of central processing unit. We get the input. Then input goes to the central processor. Here it is divided into ALU and CU. And ALU for arithmetic operations. And CU is for controlling the entire task. Memory unit. Basically, memory unit is for controlling the memory like RAM, ROM, cache memory, any type of memory where you can store your data and instructions. Memory unit is completely attached to the storage. Next, we have output. Output means we have a result that we can show to the end user. Now, we have a different types of processors. Budget processor, AMD, Sempron, Intel, Celeron. Mainstream processors, AMD, Athlon 64, Intel Pentium 4, dual core processors, AMD Athlon 64 into 2, Intel Pentium D. Means we have a different types of processor. Now it's your responsibility to select the best processor for your computer system. Because if your processor is best, you get a high performance. But if your processor is of low speed, it will damage or it will affect the performance of your computer system badly. So always use our processor very wisely for your computer system. First, we have an Intel processor. Intel Pentium dual core processor. Dual core processor provide 25% to 75% better performance than a single processor. If you are using a single processor, it will give you a average speed. But if you will use a dual core processor, it will provide more speed as compared to single processor, and it provides 25% to 75% better performance as compared to single processor. As you are using dual core processor, dual means double, so you can do more tasks, means you can go for a multitasking, and it's also support threading. Some of the main feature of Intel Pentium dual core processor is that it provides a very good performance. Multitasking, you are using dual means double means two processor, so multitasking means multiple users can use it. Low power enhancement, it does not need a improvement at any aspects, it is very good. Next, we have our Intel i3 processors. Intel processors are very common and very famous. Intel i3 processors, basically i3 was launched in January 2010, and it's dual core processors. It has graphics which make it act like a quad core. It is much powerful because it's basically very good for games. If you want to design a game in any programming language, then it's a very good processor. But for PCs, if you are using this processor on PC, you should have a good graphic card. Now the question is that you want to use the Intel i3 processor on your PC, then you have make it sure you have a very good graphic card. If you want to design a game like GTA 5, then you then make it sure that you have a very good graphic card, then you will use the Intel i3 processor. It has some features like it's a dual core processor because it have double. Maximum cache is of 3 megabits and it's a lot cheaper. It's not so expensive, it's a cheaper. Intel 5, it will be much better than Intel i3 quad core processor. It has quadratic means it has 4 cores, which enable turbo boost technology. It does not support hyper threading technology. In this, we can't go for a threading. And the cache range of these processor from 3 megabits to 8 megabits. Main features of this processor is it has 2 to 4 cores, and it's a cache range is of 3 to 8 MB, and it support turbo boost technology. Next, we have our Intel i7 processors. They were launched in 2009, 4 cores, and it has hyper threading technology. So if you are using hyper threading technology, this processor work like an 8 core processor, double than 4. It is very costly and it is super powerful because it is 8 core processor. That's why it is more costly, and it is a super powerful processor. And the cache range is 4 to 8 MB. Main features are high-end processors, 4 to 8 cores it have, turbo boost enabled, hyper threading is enabled, super expensive, and the cache is of 4 to 8 MB. Next, we have AMD processors. Main features of these processors are, in AMD, we have only 2 cores. It has Radeon graphic chip, and it is used for a low-end systems. It is not used for a high-end system. It is used for a low-end systems. AMD. AMD is not now so much famous. Now, currently the famous is Intel. It may be an i3, i5, i7. AMD A6 processors. A6, A4, A8. These are the versions. AMD A6 processors main features are dual core. Now it has 2 cores, double core. Allow turbo functioning, and it has integrated graphics. Now AMD A4 processor, it is comparable to i3, and it's low as compared to i5. Main features, Now, instead of two core, it has four cores. Graphic part faster than the Intel version, and it can handle light gaming. Not like AMD 8-core processor does not manage the heavy weight games like GTA. It can handle the very light weight game. AMD 10 processor. Main feature is 4 processor comparable with i5, and it has a good battery life, better battery life. AMD versus Intel processor. Now this is the comparison of AMD processors or Intel processor. Now it's your choice to choose which is better, good for your computer system. Either you can buy AMD processors or you can buy Intel processors. Category: processing power. Intel processors are more powerful than AMD processors. AMD FX with 6 cores perform worse than i5 and with 4 cores. But this does not mean that the AMD processors are very low at a performance. For gamers, the AMD is powerful enough. This is the category of processing power. As we know that Intel is much better to the AMD in every aspect. For gaming, for performance, Intel is much better as compared to ADM processors. Hyper-threading. Hyper-threading. Intel processors support hyper-threading, which makes them faster and more powerful even with a smaller number of cores. If your processor has a less number of cores but it supports hyper-threading, it means it is very fast. Next, we have a power consumption. Intel processor consume less power, whereas other processors will take a more power. Price. Intel processors are now currently famous in the market. It means they are more expensive as compared to other processors. Thank you so much, class. Read the difference. Agar kisi ko koi problem hai to bolo. If anyone have any problem into this comparison, then let me know. Any problem to anyone? Yes, Azmat Rahmani, any problem? Now see the syllabus. This is the syllabus we have done जो last time हमारी class लगी थी Friday, इसमें मैंने आपको computer और उसकी history करवा दी थी, types of computers, characteristics of computer. आज की class में हमने पढ़ लिया hardware, software, different hardware components and various peripheral devices, means input output devices, and different types of processors. So unit 1 is complete today. Syllabus of unit 1 is completed today. In this class, if anyone have any problem, let me know. You all are unmuted. Agar kisi ko koi problem hai, koi query hai, koi question hai, to bolo. Ajay Bhagya aur Subhagya, aapko meri awaaz aa rahi hai? Audible to you?
Yes, ma'am, aa rahi hai.
अजय भाग्या, अजय भाग्या, दोनों में से जो भी जिसको भी आवाज आ रही है, अजय भाग्या और सुभाग्या.
हाँ जी, मैं सुभाग्या बोल रहा
हूँ. सुभाग्या, आपने कब क्लास ज्वाइन की है?
मैम पिछले हफ्ते ही की.
पिछले हफ्ते?
मंडे में.
लेटरल एंट्री में हो? लीड में?
हाँ जी, हाँ जी.
ओके, ठीक है. मैंने बोल दिया है पलक को, शी विल सेंड द नोट्स इन द ग्रुप. तो आप पीसी असेंबली वाले ग्रुप में हो ना दोनों?
हाँ जी मैम.
हाँ, तो सेंड करेगी उसमें डोंट वरी, आपको कोई भी प्रॉब्लम हो रिगार्डिंग एनी सब्जेक्ट, किसी नोट्स का कोई इशू हो तो आप बता सकते हो. वी ऑलवेज देयर फॉर ऑल ऑफ, मैं और पूरी क्लास की आपको सपोर्ट और हेल्प करेगी. और किसी सब्जेक्ट में कोई किसी को प्रॉब्लम?
नो मैम, वैसे इस जो यूनिट में इम्पोर्टेंट वैसे कौन से
क्या
इम्पोर्टेंट जो एग्जाम में आ सकते हैं मैम वैसे?
वो हम एट द एंड वी विल डिस्कस बिफोर एमएसक्यू 1. यस बोलो.
क्योंकि मैम जब मैं पहले कॉलेज में पढ़ता हूँ वहाँ पे असाइनमेंट दे देते हैं ना जो जो इम्पोर्टेंट था.
ओके डोंट वरी, इसमें भी हो जाएगा. बिफोर एमएसटी 1, बिफोर एमएसटी 2 और बिफोर फाइनल एग्जाम्स वी विल शेयर और वी विल डिस्कस सम टॉपिक्स. ओके
ओके मैम.
और एनी प्रॉब्लम टू एनीवन एल्स? किसी और को कोई प्रॉब्लम? प्रॉब्लम इन एनी सब्जेक्ट? प्रॉब्लम इन एनीथिंग? No problem to all. There is a one question from Azmat Rehmani. A6, A10 different kya hai? A6 aur A10 different. Asking about the difference between A6 or A10. Azmat, A6 or A10. Main difference between AMD A6 and AMD A8 processor. The difference between AMD A6 or AMD A10 processor is that AMD A6 is a dual core. Dual means it has only two core. It has a graphic, integrated graphics, export, along, export turbo functioning. Now see AMD 10 processors, A10 processor. A10 processors code four processors. Comparable with i5. It means that was the dual core and it export four cores, double than A6. And it has a better battery life. And in case of A6, the battery issues arises lots of time, but in case of A10, there is a better battery life. Backup is good in AMD A10 processor. Recovery is good in AMD A10 processor. So this is the main difference between AMD A6 and AMD A10 processors. Read it very carefully. If anyone have any type of problem, let me know.
एंड जो प्रोसेसर है जो कोई ज्यादा बड़ा है उसके लिए पावर सप्लाई भी तो ज्यादा चाहिए होगी वैसे तो.
प्रोसेसर
जो कोई प्रोसेसर है जैसे i9 है उसके लिए पावर सप्लाई भी ज्यादा चाहिए होगी.
यस डेफिनेटली, इफ द प्रोसेसर इज कैपेबल ऑफ हैंडलिंग कॉम्प्लेक्स प्रॉब्लम्स देन इट नीड मोर पावर सप्लाई, मोर स्टोरेज स्पेस. बट इफ यू विल यूज अ powerful processor, you will get the best performance of your computer, fast speed, fast processing. But if you will go for a low and slow processor, it will completely affect the performance of your computer system. Okay.
Thank you, man. Thank you, man.
Okay. Anyone else? Any doubt? Any query to anybody else? Now we have a class on Friday. We will start with Unit 2, Module 2. All must be present. Unit 2 or Module 2. Unit 1 is completed. In this, we have studied basic history of computer, types of history of computer, generations of computer. And in Unit 1, hardware, software, and peripheral devices like input and output devices, different types of processors. That was all about unit one. And PPT and notes are already sent to all of you of unit one. Two PPTs are sent, read both PPTs very carefully. Is that clear to all? Thank you so much for attending the class. If you have any problem, agar kisi ko koi problem hogi, koi query hogi, then call me or even you can give me a text. Okay. Some of the students send the notes in the group so that Ajay Bhagya and Subhagya can get it. Is that clear? Okay. Thank you so much for. Any problem to anyone?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So thank you so much, class. Take care of yourself. Bye to all.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Bye. Thank you.